showcasing their video storytelling talents through PBS Hawaii's Hiki No program. Fantastic program, you guys. Now you get a chance to watch their amazing stories in the Hiki No Festival. So joining us this morning with more, Robert Pennebaker of PBS Hawaii. And she's also part of the program, doing, as you were mentioning, an award-winning piece that you put together. Yeah. That's awesome.
Thank you.
First, for people who are not familiar with Hiki No, even though you guys are making great waves, tell us about what you guys have been able to accomplish. This is fantastic.
Well, Hiki No is a program where middle schools and high schools across the state, private and public, produce news stories. We mentor them, we train them, we get the stories up to PBS national standards, and they air on our station every Thursday night. We have 86 schools participating, and this festival coming up is the cream of the crop. We've nominated some of the top stories from last season for awards.
Maybe this one over here.
Yeah.
All right, so tell me about that experience for you and the opportunity to be able to do this.
It's a really amazing experience to film, edit, produce all like your own stories. And the good thing about, you know, it's giving real-world situations to students and giving us the opportunity to showcase what we can really do. And if you watch all these amazing stories that they do on Hiki No, it looks like an adult put them together. Like, you know, they won't accept it if it's not up to standards. So they make sure and they train you to make sure that you meet those standards, and they give you all the tools you need, and you come out with a product that you're so proud of, and it's so worth it.
Yeah, I know you guys have some good, I think some of your equipment is better than our equipment. It's really good stuff. Okay, so tell me a little bit more about the festival, what's happening where.
Well, it starts next Monday on Maui. So we're on all the major islands, Maui next Monday, Kauai on Tuesday, then Big Island on Thursday in Waimea.
And then awards, too, right? You're going to be announcing that.
Well, these are all the nominated stories.
Okay.
And at these actual screenings, the winners aren't announced. We wanted to celebrate everyone. To be nominated is really the honor, to celebrate their work. Then the winners are going to be announced on September 17th on our website,
okay.
Live streaming.
Yeah, easy to find your guys' website if people need more information, because we got a whole bunch in our graphics, and it's hard to follow all that. So just for kids, for students out there who aren't quite sure if they should do it, if they're nervous, what would you tell them?
I would tell those students out there to definitely go out there and go to your local or your school's video class and just take a look at what it is. If you go online to the website, you can watch all of the different stories, and a lot of them are easy to connect with because it's students our age producing and writing stories that we're interested in. So it's definitely a chance for you to get your voice out there, like, oh, maybe there's a local issue going on that you know that kids really care about, and you can do that story. Maybe it's about your school, maybe it's about something in your community, and it's a chance for us to show our perspective on things. And it's just, it's an amazing opportunity. It empowers you and says, you know, like, even though I'm young, I can still do these, like, adult things and make these choices and make a video that my mom and my parents and my mother's generation will be proud of, because it's that chance to be mature and showcase all you can do.
She's good. All right. Hey, thank you very much for coming, guys.
Thank you.
And thanks for putting together such a good program.
Thanks,
thank you.
Thank you.